Kathleen Kelly. Hello, this is a coincidence. Would you mind if I sat down?
Yes, yes, I would, actually. I'm expecting someone. Thanks.
Pride and Prejudice.
Do you mind?
I bet you read that book every year. I bet you just love that Mr. Darcy, and your sentimental heart just beats wildly at the thought that he and, well, you know, whatever her name is, are truly, honestly going to end up together.
Can I get you something?
No, no, he's not staying.
Mochaccino, decaf, non-fat.
No, no, you are not staying.
I'll just stay here until your friend gets here.
Gee, is he late?
The heroine of Pride and Prejudice is Elizabeth Bennet. She is one of the greatest and most complex characters ever written, not that you would know.
As a matter of fact, I've read it.
Oh, well, good for you.
I think you'd discover a lot of things if you really knew me.
If I really knew you, I know what I would find. Instead of a brain, a cash register. Instead of a heart, a bottom line.
What?
I just had a breakthrough.
What is it?
I have you to thank for it. For the first time in my life, when confronted with a horrible, insensitive person, I knew exactly what I wanted to say, and I said it.
Well, I think you have a gift for it. That was a perfect blend of poetry and meanness.
Meanness? Let me tell you something about meanness.
Don't misunderstand me. I'm just trying to pay you a compliment.
Oh, why are you touching that? What
are you doing? Is this a red rose? No, you know, it's a crimson rose. Something you read about in a book, no doubt.
It's funny to you, isn't it? Everything is a joke to you. Please leave. Please, please leave, I beg you. Thank you.
You know what that hanky reminds me of?
Mm.
First day I met you.
First day you lied to me.
I didn't lie to you.
You did too.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I did not.
You did too.
I did
you
not.
You did too.
I did not.
Yeah, you did too. I thought all that Fox stuff was so charming. F-O-X.
Well, I didn't lie about it.
Joe. Just call me Joe.
Sure.
As if you were one of those stupid 22-year-old girls with no last name. Hi, I'm Kimberly. Hi, I'm Janice. Don't they know you're supposed to have a last name? It's like they're an entire generation of cocktail waitresses.
Look. I am not a 22-year-old cocktail waitress.
That is not what I meant.
And when I said the thing about the Price Club and the cans of olive oil, well, that's not what I meant.
Oh, you poor sad multimillionaire. I feel so sorry for you.
Take a wild guess that that's not him either. So who is he, I wonder? Certainly not, I gather, the world's greatest living expert on Julius and Ethel Rosenberg, but somebody else entirely different. Will you be mean to him too?
No, I will not. Because the man who is coming here tonight is completely unlike you. The man who is coming here tonight is kind and funny. He's got the most wonderful sense of humor.
But he's not here.
Well, if he's not here, he has a reason, because there is not a cruel or careless bone in his body. But I wouldn't expect you to understand anybody like that. You with your theme park, multi-level, homogenize the world, mochaccino land. You've deluded yourself into thinking that you're some sort of benefactor bringing books to the masses. But no one will ever remember you, Joe Fox. And maybe no one will remember me either, but plenty of people remember my mother. And they think she was fine, and they think her store was something special. You are nothing but a suit.
That's my cue. Good night.
Oh, hello, Miss Novak.
Oh, good evening, Mr. Crawley.
Well, it's quite a coincidence. I had an appointment here, too. You haven't seen Mr. Pirovich by any chance?
No, I haven't.
Well, I think I'll wait. mind if I sit down?
Yes, I do. You know, I have an appointment too, Mr. Crawley.
Oh, yes, I remember. Yes. Well, your friend seems to be a little late.
Now, thank you not to be sarcastic. I know you've had a bad day and you probably feel very bitter. Still, that's no reason
bitter,
to...
Bitter? Me? About leaving Modicek and Company? When I got home and sat down to the phone, in 5 minutes I had what amounts to 2 offers.
Well, I congratulate you. I wish you good luck.
Oh, I see you're reading Tolstoy's Anna Karenina.
Yes, do you mind?
No. I just didn't expect to meet you in a cafe with Tolstoy, that's all. Quite a surprise. I didn't know you cared for high literature.
There are many things you don't know about me, Mr. Kralik.
Uh-huh. Have you read Crime and Punishment by Dostoevsky?
No, I haven't.
I have. There are many things you don't know about me, Miss Novak. As a matter of fact, there might be a lot we don't know about each other. You know, people seldom go to the trouble of scratching the surface of things to find the inner truth.
Well, I really wouldn't care to scratch your surface, Mr. Crawley, because I know exactly what I'd find. Instead of a heart, a handbag. Instead of a soul, a suitcase. And instead of an intellect, a cigarette lighter, which doesn't work.
Well, that's very nicely put. Yes, comparing my intellect with a cigarette lighter that doesn't work. Yeah, that's a very interesting mixture of poetry and meanness.
Meanness, let me
tell you. Well, now, don't misunderstand me, Miss Novak. I'm only trying to pay you a compliment.
Mr. Crowley, please, I told you I was expecting somebody.
Look, if your party doesn't show up, would I...
Don't worry about that. My party will show up, so you don't have to entertain me.
Have you read Zola's Madame Bovary?
Madame Bovary is not by Zola. Mr. Kralik, are you still here? Are you deliberately trying to spoil my evening? Why do you want to do me harm? Why do you hate me so?
I don't hate you.
Oh, I suppose you love me.
Oh, why should I? What have you done to make me love you?
Well, I don't want you to love me.
Oh, I don't. That tune reminds me of?
Yes, thank you. 2 dozen unsold cigarette boxes.
No, wrong again. Reminds me of a girl out of a job. Very nice girl, too, I thought.
You thought that? How you can lie?
Of course, that was before you started to make fun of me, giving imitations of me in the locker room. And I'd like to take this opportunity, Miss Novak, to inform you that I don't walk like a duck and I'm not bow-legged.
Aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Well, I have information to the contrary. Mr. Vodish assured me that you have your trousers specially made.
Well, that's a lie.
Mr. Vodish, so that's the kind of a man you trust, huh?
I've never been to a tailor in my life. If you think I'm bow-legged, come on out on the sidewalk and I'll pull off my trousers.
Jesus.
How would you like it if I started making remarks about how red your hands are?
That's just exactly what you did.
Oh, no, not until after you started making fun of my legs.
My hands aren't red at all.
Oh, now, after I called your attention to them. Now, let me tell you something, Miss Novak. You may have very beautiful thoughts, but you certainly hide them. As far as your actions are concerned, you're cold and snippy like an old maid, and you're going to have a tough time getting a man to fall in love with you.
I, an old maid? So, no man could fall in love with me. Really, Mr. Crawley, you're getting funnier every minute. Why, I could show you letters that would open your eyes. No, I guess not. You probably wouldn't understand what's in them. They're written by a type of man so far superior to you that it isn't even funny. I have to laugh when I think of you calling me an old maid. You little insignificant clerk.
Goodbye, Miss Novak.
Goodbye, Mr. Crawley.